Hello everyone, I welcome you all here. Myself Anshul, I'm from BTech EC third year, member of Speakers and Club of TNT Cell of Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar. Today we are gathered here for a group discussion on the topic, how income of the farmers can be doubled in the next 5 years. Now I would like to call all the participants for their introduction.
Hi everyone, myself Aman, I'm from BTech EC third year. Today I'm here for group discussion.
Hello everyone, I'm Divya Bansal from BTech EC third year. I'm here as a part of group discussion.
Hello everyone, my name is Shagun and I'm from BTech Electronics and Communication third year and I'm here for a group discussion.
Hi, myself Franz, I am BTech third year student. Now I am in here to participate group discussion.
Hello everyone, myself Dakshrika from BTech Electronics and Communication, here as a part of group discussion.
Hello everyone, I am Prakash Jha, I am in BTech EC third year. I am here as a part of group discussion.
India is a country dominated by villages. Agriculture is the main occupation for half of the people. Farmers are regarded as the backbone of our country. If any country wants to develop, then firstly, it should make the farmers' condition better. As you all know, our country is a farming country, but the condition of the farmers in our country is not so good. So today's discussion is on the topic, how we can double the income of farmers in next 5 years. So all of you now can start.
Okay, I'll start. The income of farmer can be doubled in next 5 years. The goal is achievable if the farmer use modern technology in cultivation like drip irrigation. If they utilize the water in proper way, the every crops will get every drop of water. That scheme is Har Khet Ko Pani. And even 48% of the land in India are used for cultivation and only contribute 18% of nation's GDP. And it is a major issue that much land is used and only this much percentage of contribution in GDP. And another thing is there is lack of poverty among the farmers. Farmers are not getting their prices of their product. They had taken loan from different banks for their agriculture. And if they didn't get the good price of their products, they will get losses. And if they get losses, they have mentally pressure and they had also committed suicide in past years. So MSP should be implemented to get good prices. MSP secured the farmer product to getting good prices and sustain losses. And they will also pay the loans of their banks.
India is a vast country. And not only this, India is the most cropped country in the world, followed by USA and China. But if we talk about like export of food, China is leading the world and followed by USA. Why this happened? This is all because China is investing a lot more on its agricultural research and development sector, agricultural research and development in comparison to India. And whereas USA use a lot of new technologies in their agriculture. In order to double the farmers' income, India should need to adapt technology so that we can increase the farmers' income. If we take example of Israel is a small country in comparison to India and the other countries. Israel is completely covered with the desert, and there is no such rivers, no such big rivers that India have. India have many rivers like Ganga, Yamuna, Narmada, Brahmaputra, etc. But Israel do not have such rivers. In order to solve the problem of its water scarcity in agriculture sector, Israel adapted a system of drip irrigation. In that system, they use this drop by drop and directly directly water their plants to their directly water the plants to their roots. This not only solves the problem of their water scarcity, but also increase the income of the farmer.
Okay, I agree with your point, Shagun, but in those countries, farming is less than that of India. And also, I agree with the point by Prakash that MSP must be mandatory to our farmers. Yes. But there are certain schemes which government are running currently. For example, Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sichai Yojana and Soil Health Card is now introduced. And Parampagat Krishi Vikas Yojana is also in the process. And Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bhima Yojana, which provides insurance against the crops and income loss to encourage investment in farming. And interlinking of rivers also going on. And Operation Green, that means there is no wastage. And to address the price volatility of perishable commodities like tomato, onion, and potato. And PM Kisan Sampada Yojana is also in process. And there are various technological reforms which are currently going on. Initiating ENAM, that is National Agriculture Market, in which Kisan can online buy and purchase seeds. And Agriculture Produce Market Committee is also set up by the government. And there are certain other government schemes which are running now. So, and I agree with you all, Shagun, but there are some schemes also running in our country, and that might be helpful for the farmers. And to double up farmer income, we should promote these schemes as vast we can.
Farmers play a very important role in the growth and development, as we all know. Educating farmers is one of the major concerns in today's modern arena. Farmers require education to stay aware of new developments in technology and science that affects their agricultural operations. Education is also important to improve agricultural productivity. Also, education and earning are associated with each other. Educated person have more earning, more respect, and more dignity in the society. Education empowers farmers by raising their confidence and improving their livelihood. Knowledge will not only increase the production, but also enables people to build their identity. Education also helps farmer to escape from poverty. Education is one of the major major concern for the farmers, and education will lead to better development and growth.
As we all know, agriculture is regarded as the one of the primary occupation in rural areas. To feed the increasing population, we should adopt some techniques in agriculture. Farmers should adopt techniques. The main techniques are like irrigations, sowing of seeds, and detection of their disease and their treatments. The different techniques of irrigation are like sprinkle irrigation, drip irrigation, and basin irrigation. Sprinkle irrigation is like rainfall, and in drip irrigation, the water is provided only to the root of the plants. By this, we save water. And the main benefit of drip irrigation is the setup of drip irrigation is done by manually, and it can be controlled automatically both. And techniques used in sowing of seeds is seed drill, and it is powered by tractors. By using seed drill, we can sow the seed at a uniform distance and at a uniform depth, so the growth of plant will be perfect.
we can increase the farmer income in through various methods. Firstly, we can provide information about weather, because most of the farmer still depend on the weather condition. And secondly, we can provide increase the contract farming in India, because through contract farming, farmer easily get pesticide, fertilizer, and other equipment also. And through this income of farmer as well as crop quality is also increased in India. Why we need contract farming in India? Because most of the farmer in India still have very small piece of land. So we need it to increase contract farming in India. So we can increase farmer income as well as their quality of life. Okay.
Adding some more point to the Shriyan's views, I would like to say that MSP should be legalized so that no one can exploit farmers. And not only this, farmers should need to diversify their crops so that they can get the maximum benefit and profit, through which we can double the income of the farmers. And farmers should need to focus on biofuels. Biofuels is a fuel which is renewable, and it not only increase their income but also decrease our deficit, because our dependence on the Gulf countries for our energy requirement.
Agricultural land is decreasing day by day because many industries and buildings have been built in that area. So first of all, we have to stop that, so agriculture land can be saved and farmer will cultivate their crops in that land. And next, the farmers will start to cultivate cash crop than food crops. Cash crop will help to get to good prices, because many industries gave them good prices to their product. And cash crop helps them to increase their income as well as make their life better. And one thing is that there is no irrigation facility in all over India. In northern India, like Haryana, Punjab, there is facilities of canal. But in some area like Bihar and Rajasthan and other parts of India have not that facility. So government should have make a plan to make a canal or make an irrigation project that farmer will get water for their crops. And due to COVID-19, farmers are very intentioned. They didn't get good prices, their products. They didn't get fertilizer from the government because the utilizer haven't been exported from different countries, and many fertilizers company have been closed or shut down due to COVID-19.
Okay, I agree with you all. The most important point raised by Divya, that is about education. If farmers got educated, although farmers are educated pretty well, but there are new technologies which are coming for which farmers have to educate themselves, and government should take initiative to educate them about the latest technologies in the farming. As technologies, the main importance of technology is to reduce the man work, right? So if we are going to reduce the man work and by getting profits out of that, and we can double up the farmer income. And also the point raised by Shagun, that is about MSP. Shagun, MSP, if the government implement the MSP, but there are certain conditions there also, because MSP is minimum selling price. And if the fasal got damaged or the crop got damaged, and we can't sell the damaged crop on MSP, there are some conditions in that. So I hope that MSP will be there and government should take precautionary actions against them. And other point raised by Prakash and Shyansh said pretty well that contract farming is growing day by day, and we should adapt to double the farmer's income. And that's right. And that's all from my side.
As we know, more than 50% of the farmers are illiterate, so they don't know about the new technologies coming in across the world. So they need to be educated so that they can earn their profits also, and so that they also agriculture productivity also increase. Also, they know how much amount of chemical fertilizers are to be used. So education is very important for farmers.
As we use different techniques for irrigation and sowing of seeds for our crops, we can also sell our crops using these techniques. There is online system for selling of crops by which farmer gets good price. And there's also a biotechnology. Biotechnology is area of agricultural science involving use of scientific tools and techniques, including genetic engineering. The main application of biotechnology is fermentation. This is all from my side.
Okay, I agree with you all. And so finally, to double up the farmer income, we should educate them, and we should promote schemes which are in favor of them, and we should educate them for proper cultivation techniques and irrigation techniques also, as there are so many cultivation and irrigation techniques, and we should promote contract farming and anything. So now that's over from our side, Anshul.
You all have spoken very well. Your points were relevant and helpful. Agriculture sustains total population, half of the total population of the India. Doubling farmers' income in short such time period is overwhelming task for our decision makers. Doubling farmers' income is possible through increasing the total output and better realization of the market price. With majority of the population dependent on agriculture activities, no development can be said to be meaningful unless it includes the needs of this sector. Increasing farmer suicide rates and erratic weather conditions is also a very huge problem. So there are intense difficulties. Therefore, the focus of the government on this sector is much needed. Thank you all for participating.